Hockey Night in Canada presents me, Peter Puck, your irrepressible imp of the ice, and exciting NHL hockey. Peter Puck here again. This time I'm going to tell you about playing the game. NHL hockey, that is, the world's fastest team sport. What makes it the fastest team sport? Well, for one thing, players speed along at up to 25 or 30 miles an hour. And they, zap me about, it speeds over 100 miles per hour. We really move once a game starts. Ah. But you say you have seen the game stop. Well, of course you have. But the only time it will stop is because of a penalty, or if someone is called offside, or if someone does what we called icing the puck. First, let's take a look at the rink. The game starts right here at the center face-off circle, like this. The referee drops little old me onto the ice between the two opposing centers. Hi, guys. Now, easy does it, fellas. This is only a demonstration, you know. Oops! Wow! And the game is on! Oops! Hey, ow! Ouch! Oh, why didn't I listen to my mother and become a bicycle tire? Oops! Ouch! Or an eraser! Hold it! Whoa! Enough of the face-off. Now for the offsides that stop the game. We have two types of offside infractions. First, there's what we call offside at the blue line. The puck, that's me, must always precede the attacking players across the opponent's blue line. I can be stick-handled across, passed across, or shot across. Just as long as it's me first. However, if both skates of an attacking player cross the blue line before I do, that's a no-no. The linesman will stop play, and a face-off will take place in neutral ice at the nearest red dot. The purpose of this rule is to prevent a player from being permanently stationed in front of the opponent's goal. And now for the other offside infraction, known as the two-line pass. This offside is called when a player inside his own defensive zone passes me to a teammate standing across the center red line. Uh-uh, I cross two lines. Now when this happens, play is stopped and a face-off takes place back where the pass originated. And that takes care of the offside rules. Ah, but now we come to icing the puck. That sneaky little trick is sometimes perpetrated on yours truly when a defensive player finds the going hot in his zone and decides to cool things off by shooting me all the way. Yikes! Back down the rink and across the opponent's goal line. Whoa! Icing is called as soon as I touch one of the opposing players other than their goalie.
Sorry, Pete.
Forget it, Slim. In this case, a face-off then takes place all the way back in the defensive player's deep face-off circle. And it serves them right. You gotta play fair, you know. And speaking of play, it's time to play ball. Oh, wash my mouth out with slush. It's time to play NHL hockey. Woo! Keep your eye on me. I'm pretty fast.